So let's take a look at the solve function. I want to start with a nice little CLC clear and an SMS, I don't know, Y and stuff. I don't know, I'll just do that. So let's say I've got just some equation equals x squared, I don't know, minus 9. Now I can solve E. And basically what it's going to do is it's going to solve the 0. So it'd be x squared minus 9 is 0. So that means that x could either be positive 3 or negative 3. I want you to look, though, at the type. So instead of just calling it solve, I'll call it mug. My answer is solve. And if you look at the data type for my answer, it's a 2x1 symbol. So it's actually stored as a symbol. If I want to actually have the numbers, I need to convert that to a double. And then that will actually give me the 3 and the 3 that's actually like a double. So I actually have a number. So solve. It's kind of fun. You can do pretty much anything you want with it. If I have, let's do CLC clear, sims, A, B, C, and X. Say I have Y is equal to A times X squared plus B times X plus C. That's a quadratic function, right? So whatever equals solve y. If I'm going to solve y, it's going to come back and it's going to give me the quadratic equation, which is why whenever I do this, it originally gives me an answer if I took this out. Remember that my answer came back as a symbol, and the answer comes as a symbol because it assumes that your answer is going to be algebraic. So like down here, my answer would have to be a symbol in order for that to work, so that's why the answer does come back as a symbol. Only in certain cases can I turn it into a double. If I try to turn whatever into a double, I wouldn't be able to because, you know, I just couldn't. Because A and B and C, you know, they're variables. I just can't do it. So that's kind of fun. Most of the time, however, whenever I'm using the solve function, I'm going to use it on real equations. I'm trying to think. You can pretty much go nuts if you've got, say, y equals cosine of 3x plus sine of 3x. And you can get a little misled. So, wait, I don't do that yet. Let's just do something like, oh, remember you can't use the comma. Let's say my first equation is, I don't know, y equals mx plus b. M and B. All right, so I have y equals mx plus b. So I can solve that equation for, if I just say solve equation 1, m times x. If I just solve it, it's going to automatically solve it for x. So if I put the minus b, so y minus b, so it would be y minus b equals mx. And if I divide both sides by m, I'll get x. So I have y minus b over m. So I have minus b minus y. If you distribute the negative, that comes out right. So by nature, it's going, no, in nature, because this isn't natural at all, but by default, it's going to solve for x. But if I don't want to solve for x, I can have it solve for b. So that should be y minus mx. And yeah, y minus mx. So you can mess around with that. Let's see. Well, I was going to say a second ago, you could do something kind of weird. You could say cosine 3x plus sine 3x equals 9. So remember that you don't just have to have a single on the left if you're solving it with an equation. I can tell it to solve equation 1 for x. And it'll do it by x by default anyway, but I just like to put that in there. And then you're like, oh my gosh, that's a crazy answer. So this is something you have to remember. Because the answer is symbolic, it's giving you an exact answer. So if you use a TI-89, you're probably used to this already, that if you type in 2 over 3 in a TI-89, it says 2 over 3. It doesn't actually give you 0.6667. So this is something you need to remember whenever you're doing symbolic algebra, is that that is an absolute true answer. It is a complex answer, but there's definitely a better way to say that. And so, you know, gumbo. So I can double that. I can convert that to a double, and then that gives me the actual answers. So basically, there's two answers to that. So if I take x1, I'll say is gumbo 1. So that's that first one. If I go and everywhere I see that, I put in x1. And there's a way more efficient way to do this. We'll talk about it in a little bit. So everywhere I see the x, I'll put an x1. I should get 9. And I do. I get 9, 0, I. So there's a little bit of issue there with, whatever you call it, precision. But in general, you're going to get 9. So you really can do just about anything you want. You can break MATLAB, and I'm going to see if I can. So if I have an equation, and I'm going to make it be like x plus 3 squared plus, a plus m cubed equals 3 plus c plus y plus 4 to the, 1/4 power plus 16 times y, all right? I'm going to solve equation 1, and by nature, I keep saying this, by default, it's going to solve for x. I didn't even come close to breaking it. It's like, I got this. What's your problem? All right, so I'm going to do the sine of that and then see if that, nope, no problem. Oh, that's because the x is there all by itself. So that's always me. So let's make it solve for m now. Ooh, now that's pretty. Yay. So, this is just, I don't know why I like this so much. It just makes me super, super happy. But there's basically 6-ish answers. Now, am I going to believe this? Maybe. I don't know if I'm going to believe this or not. I'd have to actually spend some time with the solution and really be convinced that I like this. I'd probably substitute in some values to make sure that I liked it. But, you know, it's definitely a good start. It gives me something to think about. You can also use solve to solve actual equations, so like systems of equations is what I meant to say. So say I've got x and y. So say I have equation 1 is x plus y equals 6, and equation 2 is equal 6, and then x minus y is equal to 4. All right, so if I can solve this in my head, I can say, okay, well then x has to equal 5 and y has to equal 1. So that's the answer, but I'm going to see if I can get it. So a couple ways to do this. I can say solve eq1. I think this is as straightforward as that. And I run it, and so basically it's going to come back and say, x is a 1 by 1 symbol, y is a 1 by 1 symbol. So I'm going to put in, chocolate. All right, so now this has basically given me a structure, and you can see that in the data type. So it's a structure, it's a 1 by 1 structure. So if I want to know what those different values are, I can say chocobo.x and chocobo.y. All right, now you should look at this and look off to the left and say, okay, these things are left aligned. That means it's a symbol. And in fact, if I look at answer, it says answer is a symbol. So if I wanted to actually get some answers out of here, I could say I want to double that, and I want to double. I'm not gonna call it x and y, because I already have symbols called x and y. I'm gonna call it x value and y value. That way, I don't mess anything up. So I can do the solving, and I can pull the x value and the y value out of there. These can take a long time, depending on how complicated that you make it. So you do want to be careful. So if you have a linear equation, and I'm just going to make, let me finish that thought with this guy up here. So if you have this linear equation, and by linear I mean that the x isn't squared, the y isn't squared, none of the variables are squared. You probably remember from some kind of linear algebra thing that I can take the coefficients off of this. So I could say that the coefficients of that are 1, 1, and 6. And then the next ones are 1, negative 1, and 4. And there's actually a way in MATLAB where I can say, I think it's REF, that might be all there is to it. That's too many R's. I can do the row echelon form, get the row echelon form of it, and that's actually going to be fast. You can't tell that it's faster, but it is. I don't even think TikTok would tell us how fast it is. TikTok, and then talk, I don't think you're going to see anything different. Where's my first talk? Am I just too dumb? Oh, because I didn't run that. Talk. So if I run this section, 0.1 seconds, 0.09 seconds, 0.1 seconds. If I run this section, do you see? Like, that's actually kind of impressive. You can actually see the difference. So this, solving it with symbols, like I said, I'm just going to run this over and over again. I'm getting 0.1s, 0.1s, 0.1 seconds. And you're like, well, what's the big deal? 0.1 second versus, so it's a tenth of a second versus somewhere around 2/1000ths of a second or 3/1000ths of a second. But we're on the order of magnitude of 1/1000ths of a second instead of 1/10ths of a second. And like I was trying to say a second ago, this could be worse the more that I have. So I'm just going to make up some, I'm going to keep it in order just to make it plus, I don't know, 8, whatever. And then equation 3, we'll have no zeros, and then 6y, well, I'll make it all complicated, minus 3x plus 12y plus 18z equals negative 56. All right. So I have this. Now if I want to solve, blah, solve EQ1, EQ2, and EQ3, and then I can get blah dot x and blah dot y and blah dot z, and I can make them doubles. Whoa! And there's got to be a better way to do this. I'm just tired. Maybe x value, y value. Alright, and oh. Alright, so that wasn't too bad. And it might also be taking longer because I'm printing out. I just thought of that. That might be taking longer. But I'll tick-tock it. So yeah, I guess printing it out was taking some time. But nonetheless, I can go through here and so if you can, pause the video and see if you can solve this using the row echelon method. So pause it for a second, see how far you can get. We'll assume that happened. 1, 3, 5, and 19. And then negative 1, 5, 7, and 22, negative 3, 12, 18, and negative 56. So I'm gonna whatever and ref that. I'm gonna tick-tock it. And tick-tock isn't perfect either. But it's still faster. You can still tell. So 0.05, 0.05-ish, and this is 0.002-ish. So I'm gonna CLC clear this, but it's important to remember that the RREF thing only works whenever I have a linear system. So if I had this and any part of it, if any part of it had a square in it or a sign in it or a square root in it or an e to the whatever in it, all bets are off insofar as using linear algebra. The only way to solve this now is going to be to use some kind of a numerical method, which we can have MATLAB do for us. And so now, I'm sure this is going to take forever. There we go. So that wasn't too bad. So blah dot x and blah dot y and blah dot z. Oh, of course, I have to wait again. I was not thinking ahead. Doop doop doop. There's my exact answers. So I'm going to pull this from here. I'm not going to rerun it. I'm just going to paste them here. All right. And so then I can get some values for x, y, and z. So going from linear to nonlinear surely makes a huge difference in how long things take to run. So that's something else to keep in mind as well. The good news is that if you're using this here, things don't have to be in order the same way that they would if you were doing this with a linear stuff. With the linear algebra stuff, you've got to have all your stuff on the left and any kind of talking is hard. Any kind of constant goes on the right. So the nice thing about this is I can have just a total cattywampusy looking kind of thing. And that actually solved faster. That's interesting. So just more to keep in mind that there's you're really starting to see, hopefully, that there's just absolutely no limit on what you can do with this.